eye level, and this is the center of this. Usually, where this is aiming is where something, usually what is creating the expression is coming from. So let's say this character's here, there's something over here, maybe it's a cheeseburger or something. The character is really excited. This line is where I start the eyes. And usually I just do really rough light sketches for the under drawing. And so this is where the nose would be, since we're drawing furry characters. Usually this line I continue into the muzzle. And then this down here would be the chin area. So I just kind of roughly figure it out. So let's say this character is really surprised. When a character is surprised, usually the scene where they go, their eyes are open. So their eyes may have more of a kind of like an anime style rainbow kind of upside down U effect. If you want more of a plain surprise, you can have just the straight lines from the underside of the eye. Or if you want to have more of a shocked look, you can create another kind of U to kind of show the cheeks pushing up to kind of conceal the bottom of the eyes. Now the eyes, let's just say, when the pupils are small, it conveys fear, shock, surprise, excitement. If you have really big eyes, it's kind of more of a normalized look. Or they're cracked.
They're red and gray color.
Yeah, bloodshot.
Obviously, what you didn't drink.
It's been at a burger.
I need that burger. Correct ketchup.
So let's give them more of a look here. Now, the key thing is the eyebrows. You can do, normal eyebrows, so it's kind of like, that's pleasant. Or, if you want to convey some kind of tension, what I do is I draw the brows kind of like a frown, like the eyebrows tuck inward and push upward and furrow the brow. And when I do that, I usually cut off the top of the eye. Because if I just do it up here, it looks okay. It looks very cartoony. And it's still, with my style, still kind of cartoony, but if you have more like that, it has a little bit more impact. And you can kind of do some lines to furrow. When the nostrils can increase the size when someone's scared or surprised or whatever, so you may draw the nostrils bigger than usual. I'm drawing a giraffe, by the way, because I always draw giraffes. vaguely giraffe-ish. I'm drawing this from the side person. So, the mouth is a very key part. So, let's say you want to draw the mouth like a woman kind of thing. You might draw, that kind of thing. Or, you want to do something a little more advanced. You could do, underside of the muzzle, up a little bit because the mouth curves, and then goes down again to convey that kind of, the jowls come down to show shock or awe or whatever. And then I kind of judge where the other lip is, and then I move the two different. Now, I usually draw a little bit of the lip, and then I kind of redraw the jawline. I have to adjust, because the basic circle is for the face shape. Want to adjust where the mouth is going, we're going to have to go lower, higher, or whatever. And then I just draw a little bit of curve here for the tongue. Now, this is for shock. Let's say we want to make this character really happy that burger is there. Like they haven't eaten the entire con, they are just starved. So, again, we can do the U shaped. Upside down use for the eyes. We can even again do the cheeks in a kind of curved thing. So it's almost like you have two U's, but this one is a lot flatter. For excitement, I usually draw bigger eyes. Maybe do some kind of highlight to show the kind of sparkle. Oh my gosh. Eyebrows are almost always. Yeah. eyebrows are almost always a little higher, maybe a little brow higher. And you know, if when you raise your brow, sometimes the scalp pushes back, maybe the hairline's a little higher. Because your key thing is the eyes. The eyes are going to be what people see first. That's going to give them the most expression. Now, again, you have the under curve and the upper curve, but since this character's happy, we will have the curve above. Maybe have the lip part and come down again. Very similar, but you can see how just the, you know, going down. This one, and then there's this one, and how just that one curve can make all the difference. Now let's say, on the other side here, let's say you have a character that's looking kind of sassy. What I usually do is I kind of go for a more straight line, and then I go down. So I make sort of like a trapezoid shape, and then I do a little bit of the eyelid, so that it looks like the eyes kind of half-slitted, eyebrow or whatever. I might emphasize the upper eye lashes here, so I can make the eye kind of half hidden. The highlight can be adjusted to match that. A lot of people, one thing I want to say real quick, a lot of people will draw an and let's say they have the eyelid or whatever. And I've seen people do shading, where the shading goes across like this, like a darker shade. They'll put the highlight there. And that doesn't work because, I mean, you can have some great highlight in the shading, but if you have a pretty good shadow and you have a bright white highlight, it's kind of like, where's the light coming from? Because if they have a shadow like this, you kind of imply the shadows are coming some degree down. And then you have a highlight up towards the top of the shadow. Most likely your highlight's going to be down here, or here. So that's one thing to keep in mind, is know where your highlight's coming from, because I mean the highlight's going to be like really gives the light to the eye. So like if you have an eyeball and you just have it looks lifeless.
So you got wrong.
Yeah. Just, you know, haven't been drinking for days. But if you add a highlight to it, you use some kind of darker shade with an iris, it has a little more oomph to it.
Yeah, it gives more highlight.
Yeah, just more highlight. Yeah, in that case, the